Ollie Rayner took 4 wickets as Middlesex rolled Durham on day one. Durham visited top of the table Middlesex, looking to inflict a first defeat on the runaway leaders. Durham won the toss and batted, and openers Stoneman and Jennings started brightly, putting on 74 in the first 16 overs at the healthy rate of 4.5 an over. However, Durham then completely came undone, with 74 for none becoming 78 for 4 in the space of 17 balls, with first Stoneman top-edging Franklin to be caught behind for 46. And then Jennings falling LBW in Franklin's next over for 27. Rayner then bowled Borthwick for a duck with the first ball of the 20th over. And the very next ball, a yes-no call from Richardson, saw Burnham run out without scoring, Durham in complete disarray. Richardson was then given a life when a regulation chance at slip went begging off the bowling of Rayner, and he and Collingwood then survived through to lunch, Durham 101 for 4 at the break. The afternoon session didn't start well for the visitors, with Richardson mistiming a pull shot in the first over to be caught by Malan off Murtagh for 17. 3 balls later and Durham was 6 down, Collingwood caught by Compton driving on the up, Podmore the bowler. Durham found themselves 130 for 7 when Hickey was adjudged caught behind off Franklin for 7, no one more surprised than the bowler himself. Coughlin and Wood then came together to try and lend the score some respectability, with both batsmen playing some fine shots in a partnership of 40. However, that's where the partnership was to end, Coughlin LBW playing across the line to Rayner for 39. Wood continued to find the cover boundary, but his partner Rushworth made just 15 before he holed out to deep long on off Rayner, 3 overs before the tea break. Middlesex then wrapped up the innings just 3 balls before the interval, Wood caught by Stirling at deep mid-wicket, Durham all out for 204 inside 2 sessions. Not a pretty looking batting card then for Durham, with several batsmen getting a start, but no one going on to pass 50. Openers Stoneman and Jennings gave the visitors a bright start, with a partnership of 74, but Durham then lost 4 wickets for no runs in the space of 3 overs. Coughlin and Wood managed to take the total past 200, but Middlesex were well and truly in the driver's seat after the first 2 sessions of play. Eskenazi and Gubbins came out firing for Middlesex in reply, with both batsmen finding the boundary early on. Eskenazi set off for a single, but failed to spot Onions, crunching into the Durham man, with both batsmen and bowler ending up on the turf. However, Eskenazi dusted himself off to continue his partnership with Gubbins. Middlesex looked set to finish the day without loss, but Onions grabbed the wicket of Eskenazi for 42, Middlesex 77 for 1. Gubbins and Compton saw the host through to stumps without further loss, with Middlesex in a commanding position, 104 runs behind Durham's first innings total, with 9 wickets still in hand.